Hello, my name's Julia, and today is a very special day. I ordered a Paul Young wig, and it just came. This is my first wig ever purchase. Don't know what to expect. I've watched plenty of these YouTubes, and we shall see if this is something that I'm going to like. So, Paul Young. I see everybody do this. It is Dylan in the color SF613/14. I think it was Golden Lights. Hopefully it matches this color that I'm sporting right now. So let me open it up. Oh, I think it's going to match. There it is. With the tag. SF613/14. And now I'm actually doing what all these women do on the videos. This is cool. Wow, she's prettier than I thought. She mimics, I think, my hair pretty much, the hair that I have left, I should say. It could be a little bit redder, but I think I can get away with it. Just said fresh out of the box. I know I can't do anything. Now, I bought her on sale, so I don't think she's returnable, from what I understand. This says exchange within 60 days, refund within 30. This product cannot be returned once this bag has been removed. Once this tag has been removed. So, anyway, I'm going to put you on hold and try it on. Okay, so I put it on. It looks very wiggy to me. I did not shake it. I just put it on. I thought that when I ordered this, because it was on sale, that it's not returnable. So, but it says exchange policies within 60 days, excluding rush services or all $29.99 wigs. So with that being said, minus a $19 restocking fee per item. So I guess, I don't know. It was a first time purchase. It was total was $62. I don't mind the fit. It fits me well, but I don't know what I'm going to do about the shine. I didn't shake it yet either, so I think I'm going to keep it. We'll see. Okay, I'm back. I did a little bit of reconfiguring here. I brought out some of my own hair. I didn't do such a great job. I brought out some of my own hair to try and cover up the harshness of that. It's just, like everybody says, it's a lot of hair. I haven't had this much hair since I was in my 20s before I came down with a thyroid disease. So, you know, this it just seems like it's... this style, it's not mono... filament. It's not lace, or I just wanted something to cover my forehead. I didn't want to spend the extra money on the lace front when I didn't think you were going to see it. The shade, I think, is perfect. It's very shiny. So I have to, like they said, you have to wash it to get it out, to get the color out. This side is automatically, my right side is longer, it seems to be, than my left. I don't know. It could be an optical illusion. I don't like how the roots are not darker, so I do, the next wig would be rooted. I think that they are more realistic. I've had this on all of about maybe 10 minutes. It is hot. I'm feeling hot, but then I'm very anxious. I want to try and keep my bio hair as long as this. So if a day I'm wearing it up, I can just wear my natural hair up and cover all the spots that I need covered And in the days where I don't, I would just put this on. That's my logic behind this. I'm also looking at another one from Paul Young already, yesterday or day before. And that was called, not Madison, Mason. Mason. And it's, they have this shade. I think it was a shade. This or that one or Charlie, I forget which. One that didn't have my color, this Golden Lights, which, like I said, it's pretty dead on to what I dye my hair. So I think all in all, for my first wig, I have to learn how to cover my bump in the back. I'll do that because my hair is right here. And so I have to learn how to do that. I really didn't comb it. I think the part is still kind of, you know, messed up a little bit. But for $60, I'm going to keep it. I'm not going to return it and get a $20 restocking fee and lose $20. I'll just keep it and play with it. I think I'm going to try and put roots in it. Definitely dull it down. And I think if I wear it to church on Sunday, I don't know if people are, they're going to notice something's different. But people that don't know me, they haven't seen me in a while because I missed two Sundays in a row. So church, my church people may not notice, you know, if I can fix. I also wanted to see if I could wear it in a down ponytail. And in the mirror, it looks like I can, like a little, I mean, I usually either wear headbands or I do wear it up in a scrunchie. I don't think I can wear this up in a scrunchie, but I can wear, it looks like with a little tiny tie backs or something, because I have to bring more of my own hair out. So that's what I'm playing with, trying to bring more of my own natural hair out to cover up, like that's my natural hair, to cover up the harshness of that, of not having a lace front. So, all in all, I have to say, I think it's a good first wig. Once I take the shyness away and play with it and make it my own, I think I will wear this and not have a problem with it. I do think the bangs are also a little bit too long. I like bangs. I don't like the side sweep. So I do like a little bit of the bang, so I probably will be cutting. I think say now really looks a lot better if I was to cut the bangs just a smidge. I think it's more believable. And then comb out a little bit more of these ringlets and make them more not so shiny. That seems to be the overall problem with this, is that it is too shiny for me. My hair. The hair that I do have is not this shiny. So I know that can be remedied. Everybody says just wash it or put the powder on it, the dry shampoo, which I have. So, but I think with the bangs, it's just, that's me. That is me. So I did get my first wig to match my dyed skin. This is what I use. I don't even use peroxide in my hair. I haven't for years. This stuff just washes in and it washes out. Can't beat the price. $3 at Walmart. And, you know, leave it in 20 minutes every 6 weeks and it covers up my gray. You know, I'm happy with it. And so, yeah. So, anyway. All right. Now I should find a place to post this video. let me know what you think, what I'm doing wrong. Like I said, I know I have a bump here. That's my natural hair. I don't want to braid my hair in, like, what do you call that? Cornrows or something. I don't want to do that. I'm trying. The reason why I'm wearing wigs right now, I want to give my hair a rest for the winter. It is so dry, and I am on supplements. I take my vitamins. My thyroid levels are perfect. I am in menopause, so I think it's just whatever, it's my hair. And this is what I've been thinking about doing this for over a year. Literally checking the videos out, checking all the women out, checking the sites out, never just taking that plunge. And my aha moment was last week at work. It was a bad day. It was like a rainy day. And I had my hair up in one of these scrunchies, like I normally do. And I covered it all up, and I put the topics on, and I did the sides. And for whatever reason, I pulled out my little compact mirror, looked at myself at my desk. And my hair had separated here. You could see my balding spot here. That's why I'm not wearing toppers. I don't want to put any more pressure on right here, which is where I lost some hair. And I couldn't believe how bad I looked and how bad that made me feel. That was it. I came home last Tuesday night and went online. I must have spent two nights nonstop after work looking at all the ones, and this is the one that I kept going back to. I find another one, and the prices were crazy high for me to spend for my first wig. I wasn't going to do that. I know there's pros and cons with spending cheaper on your first wig because you can't really relate it to the $250 wigs. But in my mind, I wasn't going to spend $250 for a wig. I just wanted to feel what it was like on my head first. Now, it's been on my head for maybe 20 minutes, and I'm already getting used to it. And that's with the tag sticking out of the back and the tag here. So I'm already getting used to it. You know, it already, the heat of putting it on at the first minute is finally going away. So, yeah. The only thing this doesn't have, it does not have ear tabs. It has like an open, there's nothing there. But I guess it's good because I have glasses. So when I went to try and center the ear tabs, there weren't any. There was nothing there. It's just like two little tiny clips. So, and to get my hair in the hairnet is another thing. I did order a wig grip today, as a matter of fact. But I don't think this thing's going anywhere. I mean, the barrette is, but I don't think my hair is. I think it's on there pretty well because of all my natural hairs is keeping it on. But anyway, all right, thank you out there for giving me the confidence to do this. I watched Lisa M., Judy Penny, Sugar Puff and Fluff, Taz from Taz's Wigs Closet. Oh my gosh, there's more. There's Sister Wigs. I have checked them all out two, three times, each of them, some of them. And yeah, so thank you very much, and God bless. Bye.